Now, it's usually a night reserved for horror stories and kids hyped up on sugar, but this Halloween, two Melbourne schoolboys ended up as heroes. While trick-or-treating, 12-year-old Jake and 11-year-old Roy found an elderly neighbour in real trouble after a fall and came to her aid.
And the local legends, Jake and Roy, join us now! Yay! So good to speak to you, boys. Jake, let me start with you. How did you know your neighbour was in trouble?
We were knocking on the door and my mate Roy, he was about to say, no, let's just go. And I was like, no, let's just wait one more second. And I heard her calling out for help. And then I said, hey, are you okay? And she said, no, I've fallen over, I can't get up. Ooh. So I ran across the street and I got a lovely couple, lovely. And I got them to come over and help out. And we found the spare key, got in there and helped her out.
And did a part of you think almost that it might be someone Halloween pranking you saying that? Or did you know straight away it was someone in trouble?
Nah, I can kind of tell because, like, she kind of had a worried sound in her voice, and I said, are you okay? And she said, no, I've fallen over, I can't get up. So they told us where the spare key was. We found the key, it was wrapped in foil for some reason. We got it out, we got in there, helped her out, and she was lying and she was leaning on the chair, on her lounge room chair, and she said that her leg was in pain and she might have broken it, and she had bruises on her legs and on her leg, and yeah, she was sitting there for like 20 minutes straight before we came there.
How are you feeling at this point, Roy?
At that point, I was scared because it's never happened before and it was just something new.
Yeah, I can imagine it's new. I mean, this has never happened to me and I'm much older than you, mate. I understand, Roy, you were the one to stay with Esma and then keep her calm. How did you do all that?
Yeah, Jake went to go get help. Well, I was telling her that it's fine and that my mate's getting help and not to worry.
But also, how lucky was this? Because if it wasn't for Halloween, would you have ever been down that street?
No, not really, no.
We weren't almost going to even go down to the units.
Yeah, we weren't even going to go. And then I said, no, come on, Roy, we've never been. Let's just try out. And then we tried and then another unit gave us a kiwi fruit for some reason.
Oh, you know why? That's all they had. One year we got given a $2 coin by a nun and a packet of biscuits from an old man.
That's great, though. You got a kiwi fruit.
You two are such brave and beautiful boys that if I was your mum, I would be so proud of you because a lot of people would have chosen not to answer the call, you know, because it's kind of scary and weird.
Yeah, when I got home, my mum, she was really proud, and my brother, he was proud of me as well.
Guys, I hope this doesn't sound like too much, but I hope you're in the Marvel Universe next.
No. Honestly, I'd rather be in the DC Universe.
Oh. Yeah. Hey, well done, boys. Such an incredible story. So great to speak to you. Really, really happy that we had this chat.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Absolute legends. They should have their whole new thing.
Yeah, Roy's Batman. He's the Batman.
Quiet, brooding. Yeah, I love it.